guys, I hope you are doing well. I don't know about you, but I love onions. Whether it's raw onions, fried onions, onions on a hoagie, raw or fried on a cheesesteak, caramelized onions, maybe with sausage and peppers and onions. Have you ever had that? Baked onions. That's a great thing to do with any kind of vegetable, especially the root vegetables. Bake them for about an hour at around 450, I think. It's been a while. But you can bake onion, garlic, potato, of course. What else? Brussels sprouts. I think asparagus. You have to be careful with some of the more tender vegetables. They can get a little overcooked. But baking onions or any other vegetable in the oven really brings out the sweetness. It's great. And what else? French onion soup. I love that. And of course, having red onions in salad. I love that type as well. So what I initially was going to do was just eating an onion. I was going to buy a yellow onion, slice it in half, and just eat it. You know, but I thought, after, you know, thinking it through a little bit more, let's do this tasting video where I taste the different varieties, eat them, and kind of celebrate the splendastic nature that is onions. And I will be bringing our esteemed guests of honor out here in just a moment. I'm going to bring out one, each one at a time, and then I have a little printout just to provide a brief description of each type of four onions that I'll be tasting here. Because whether you know or not, unfortunately, I am not an onion connoisseur. I'm sorry, okay? However, I do want you to know that I am going to college to get a degree in onionology, okay? Alright, so that's it for the bad jokes. Let's bring out each of the onions. I'll just set my little cheat sheet right here. We shall start with the white onion. We can just tap on this a little bit. Some onion tapping. So this is the white onion. I'll just place that there. White onion is a cultivar of dry onion that has a pure white papery skin and a sweet, mild white flesh, similar to red onions due to the high sugar content. They have a short shelf life, lasting up to 2 days, or if refrigerated, they can last up to a month. This onion is used in Mexican foods or complementing the flavors of other ingredients. The onion can be sauteed to a dark brown color and served to provide a sweet and sour flavor to other foods. And when they talk about sauteing to a dark brown color, that's like the caramelized onion I think they're talking about. Small white onions used in soups, casseroles, or stews. They are known as boiler onions. They can also be added to salads. Okay. is a variety of dry onion with a strong flavor. They have a greenish white, light yellow or white inside. Its layers of papery skin have a yellow brown or pale golden color. It is higher in sulfur content than the white onion, which gives it a stronger, more complex flavor. A dozen varieties of yellow onion are grown following the time of year. They vary in nutritional content, but they do contain quercetin, if that's how you pronounce it. It's a flavanol. Yellow onions are typically available throughout the year, grown between spring and fall, and then stored for the rest of the year. It is the most commonly grown onion in Northern Europe, and it makes up 90% of onions grown in the United States. It has a rich onion taste and is fit for many various food dishes like French onion soup, like I said, one of my favorites, other soups, stews, and braises, sautéed dishes, and shish kebabs. I love those too. They can become sticky and sweet when caramelized. Okay, so maybe they use brown yellow onions for caramelizing. I don't know, whatever. You can pretty much caramelize either one. You can pretty much caramelize any onion, I think, but probably more common the yellow or the white. Okay. So that's the yellow onion. Next we have the red onion, and we'll do a little, there's that papery. Onions are cultivars of the onion with purplish red skin and white flesh tinged with red. These onions tend to be medium to large in size and have a mild to sweet flavor. They are often consumed raw, grilled, or lightly cooked with other foods, or added as a decoration to salads. They might be added as a decoration, but I'll eat them if they're in a salad. They tend to lose their color when cooked. Red onions are available throughout the year. They are high in flavonoids and fiber compared to white and yellow onions. Okay. Just cooperate. There we go. Okay, and lastly, let's bring out our final, fourth and final esteemed guest of honor. Vidalia onion. Can you hear some of that? Papery outside there. Onion is one of several varieties of sweet onion, not as pungent as other onions, grown in a production area defined by law of the U.S. state of Georgia since 1986 and the United States Code of Federal Regulations. Varieties include the hybrid yellow granix, varieties of granix parentage, and similar varieties as recommended by the Vidalia Onion Committee and approved by the U.S. Secretary of Agriculture. I find that funny that the Vidalia Onion has its own committee. The onions are named Vidalia because they were historically grown in the town of Vidalia, Georgia. I did not know that until now. The cultivation of Vidalia onions started in the early 1930s. The different varieties are unusually sweet compared to other onions due to the low amount of sulfur in the soil in which Vidalia onions are grown. The Vidalia onion was named Georgia's official state vegetable in 1990. That's something else I didn't know, that states had official vegetables. Or maybe they don't. Maybe it's just Georgia. I don't know. Okay. So, this is all four of the onions that I will be eating raw. The last thing I want to talk about is just some of the vitamins and minerals that are found in onions. We have thiamine, B1, niacin, B3, pantothenic acid, B5, vitamin B6, folate, B9, vitamin C, calcium, iron, magnesium, manganese, phosphorus, potassium, sodium, and zinc. Depending on the Vidalia onion, I think might have more, a couple more or less vitamins and minerals compared to the others. So, alright, well, I think that all the educational stuff and information is out of the way. Let's get started. I thought I'd start with the more mild onions first. That way, the stronger onions won't overpower the taste of any onions I might have after. Well, that's my thought anyway. So, let's start with the sweet Vidalia first. Just move these off to the side. Alright, so let's peel this. Actually, I'm just gonna cut it in half and then peel it. That way, a little bit easier. So let's cut this right in half. This is not the sharpest chef's knife. It used to be very sharp, but then I just ended up not taking care of the blade like I should. Still does a job, but it's not as sharp. Kind of like me. It's a little dull. Off. taste that classic Vidalia onion sweetness. And of course, that onion, it's like that spicy, it's not spice, but how else to describe it? A little bit of heat, I guess you might say. I'll take another bite. So far, so good. Let us try. Just want to look at my cheat sheet again to see which of the last of the next three are more mild. Let's see. Red onions, mild to sweet. Stronger flavor is the yellow, and the white doesn't say too much. Okay, so we'll use the yellow. Yellow onion last. Let's do the red onion next. Just cut that in half. That's good. Whew. I don't think I'm gonna have three bites. Oh. down there in my stomach, just not, just on the verge of being queasy, a little, not nausea, but it's a little unsettling, which I knew it was going to be. I knew it was going to be a challenge to do this, but I thought it'd be fun. Anyway, all right, so just take a little bit of water, maybe that will help calm my stomach down a little bit. Okay, let's do one more bite of the red onion. Second, my nose is, I don't know what it is, all of a sudden I feel like my eyes are tearing up just a little bit, and my nose, I think my allergies are acting up. Okay. Alright, that was quite a lot of onion. I didn't think it would be that too big of a deal, but I just want to take a moment to let my stomach settle down just a little bit before I starting to reach that level where I don't want to eat any more onion. Okay, two more onions to go. Let us do the white onion next. Some onion skin sounds for you. I do this while my stomach calms down a little bit from all that raw onion. So far, so good. center. Just get that back in there. All right. Okay. Let's try that. White onion. Again, my allergies or something make my eyes burn. What that is. Okay. Okay, I can only do one bite and maybe one bite more. All this onion, it's really strong and it's doing a little bit of a number on my stomach. So, I'm going to take it a little bit easier. The Vidalia onion, eating that raw, just like that, wasn't too bad. The red onion was tough. That was a little just stronger in terms of the raw onion. The white onion, definitely a little bit stronger. Not as bad as the red. You know, when I have red onion in a salad, it's just the small, thin rings, okay? You're not just taking whole bites out of it, you know? Okay, one more onion to go, and that is the yellow onion. Might be a little stuffy. From whatever is causing my eyes to water a little bit and my nose to run a little bit. I don't know what that might be. I have a feeling it might be all the pollen. I do have seasonal allergies, so. Okay. Let's peel this. Bite of onion, and that's it for me. You know, the way I feel a little bit reminds me of how I used to feel when I used to drink alcohol, and you start to feel that you've had one too many drinks, and you're like, all right, that's the last drink, because if I have any more, I'm going to get sick. So it's like that. One more bite. Let me just get a little bit more water here. All right. Here we go. This is the yellow onion. See you in another video real soon. So long.